Hello and welcome to another Franchise Hockey Manager Stream. My name is Adam. I'm the community manager of Franchise Hockey. With me, as always, and not pictured on your screen, is every time producer Jeff. Say hi, Jeff.
Hey, everybody.
And we are back with Fire the Cannon 2004-2005 Columbus Blue Jackets season start. Jeff, last time we were doing this, we did the off season. We made a bunch of trades. We did our draft. I just have up our current roster, what it looks like. Just doing a quick recap, if we go to our transaction log here, our big thing was we traded away Timo Solani for a first-round pick. We also traded, Eric Cole for a first-round pick and Andy Green for a first-round pick, and we basically traded our way up the draft. That let us pick up... Was it just who did we pick up in the draft? I'm trying to remember.
Andrew Ladd.
Okay, so I'm just gonna pull.
And then Chris Versteeg later in the round.
Right. Yes, we loaded up on Chicago Blackhawks.
Yep.
NHL entry.
Well, this was the Ovechkin Malkin draft. So Ovechkin wound up going to Carolina and Malkin to Nashville.
Yes. I guess we go the other way here. Yeah, we should have actually traded up and got Krejci. We didn't. That was a mistake. But yeah, we took Andrew Ladd, Chris Versteeg, Alex Edler, picked up Khudobin as another goaltender. And then we took Roman Wick, who played a tiny bit in the league, I think. Dustin Boyd, yep. Brian Young, and then just picked the 6'7" Boris Valabik. Yeah. So we feel pretty good about our draft. We're still sitting pretty high in the prospect rankings. As I said, we made some moves here to, we picked up Craig Anderson via the waiver draft, who immediately came in and, well, we didn't have to send him down to the minors because he wasn't signed. We didn't have to keep him on our team.
That's a mistake with the waiver draft. That little loophole there that let you take him, we shouldn't have done. I got to fix that for 10, but.
The things we learned. So yeah, we're pretty stacked at goal again. And I mean, we could move Kari Lehtinen or Craig Anderson if the right deal comes up for us now that we got some depth, because we still have Curtis Sanford too. And then we have the, what was Gustafson's name? Was it the Moose? What was his
nickname?
Monster, the Monster.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Okay. I was like, no, the one time Winnipeg Jet, everybody forgets us, but he never actually signed.
So are you going with these, where, what lines are you going with to start the season?
That's a great question. That's kind of where we ended. So we got to fix this because we don't have Kovalchuk in the lineup. Everybody's at 100% right now. We do have...
Kovalchuk has been really disappointing offensively so far.
No, I mean, we're...
Fourth year in the league, he hasn't broken 35 points yet. I say put him on the first line with Datsyuk and let him go nuts.
Well, he was. That's where he has been playing.
It's been the second line, hasn't it?
No.
I mean, that 6-point production hasn't been...
Pretty sure.
Or is that just because you don't give any ice time to your first line?
Oh, Pavel Datsyuk, excellent line chemistry. So he's been playing with him.
Okay, so he's been playing with him, yeah.
Yeah, Antropov's excellent too. Sean Horkoff's good. Yeah, they just haven't quite... He hasn't quite his stride yet. Okay, so we got... 4, 5, 6. Okay, so who's coming out? Dominic Moore's coming out. Kovalchuk's going in. We don't have Nedved in. Derek Roy. Okay, we actually do have a lot of forwards here. I guess Alex Burrows is coming out. Antropov's coming in. Roy's out. Ruutu's in. And Nedved.
Wonder if it might be better to put Burrows in for Moore. He's 1 year younger, and you're going to be keeping Burrows probably longer than you will Moore. Moore's going to be gone after this year.
Moore's already off now. Oh, wait. We only have 16 guys dressed. Okay, this makes more sense. Yeah. Bergeron, Nedved, Roy. Okay, there we go. So Moore is our third guy. Or 13th guy, not third guy. There we go. That makes more sense. Okay, having just the lines made here. Yeah, it's putting Kovalchuk on the second line. No, he's going to play on the first line with Datsyuk. We had Antropov up on the first line, but it wants to put Justin Williams.
Yeah, I think that makes more sense.
Patrice Bergeron's going to start as our fourth line center, centering Yzerman and Derek Roy. I forgot we got Daniel Cleary, so he's on our third line. Do you want to move him down to the fourth line?
Yeah. Joe, you got him for high note, right? Okay. Third or fourth? That's
okay. What if I move Bergeron up and move Ruutu to the wing?
You're putting Bergeron on the third line already?
Well, he's 1.5 stars. He's going to get... Okay, fine. We'll leave it. Leave him on the fourth. Okay, so we go 18, 17, 14, 11 for our lines. Do you want Williams on the top line?
More line on the first line, I think. I'd
put what, sorry?
More, I'd give the first time. You're only giving 18 minutes a game to the first line?
Well, they have special teams, too.
Yeah, but still, I mean, that's... You're not going to... It's not going to add... ice time beyond that 18.
Nah. I don't think that's bad, but fine.
I think that's 19. Part of the reason they're not producing quite as much.
Oh, come on. They got lots of time. Yeah. 35 points, he should be getting tons, or he should be getting way more than that with that much ice time.
Yeah, so he does. This is also the tail end of the dead puck era, too. Before they, well, they went crazy for a year and started handing out a ton of power plays. First post-lockout year, and then kind of faded back and then started coming back up again.
Red Sixers fan, oh, sorry, it wasn't where there's a hockey version of this game. All right, well, thanks for tuning in for the first time then, Red Sixers fan. 3-0 win versus Atlanta to open up our season. McDonald scores, Antropov scores, Ruutu scores. 18 shots, not bad. Mike Dunham is on waivers, but we don't really need a goaltender, so...
Nope.
Oh, there's a name I haven't heard. Andrei Kovalenko is on waivers as well.
But he's finished.
No.
Half stars, yeah.
Marian Hossa to be traded? So we have to go out and get him then, right? That's what we're supposed to do? Stop him from going to Atlanta? We're just going to sim through some of this.
Because you could afford another big salary.
Absolutely. 3-2 win.
The other thing, but the cap is coming in next year, and it's going to be $32 million to start, I think. 32 or 35.
Well, that's why we trade away. We're pretty good right now. Ooh, there's a storyline you haven't heard for a while. Thrashers players unhappy with ice quality. According to local beat reporter source, Atlanta players have approached management to voice concerns about the condition of the Southeast Division's team's ice. The players met together in a private meeting before the team's practice and appointed an unnamed player to meet with owner Bruce Leverson and head coach Barry Trotz to air complaints about the ice surface upkeep. Apparently, the meeting's results was not satisfactory to the players, and it is questionable whether it will hurt the fifth-place team morale. What's our salary cap rate? Or our current salary is $32.5 million with an almost
full. Yeah, you'll roster. Be okay. You got enough room. It's going to be tighter from this point in, but particularly once if somebody has a big season, you've got to start re-signing the Datsuks and the
lost our first game to Colorado.
Burroughs gets the first goal of the season.
Yes. Up 2-0, and then we blew it. And Kovalchuk just got injured. Awesome.
So much for him being productive this year.
Bruised hip. He's only day-to-day. Okay. Trade proposal from Buffalo. Buffalo wants to send us 31-year-old Peter Ferraro for Dominique Moore. No. Ha, 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 ha. I forgot about this storyline too. I haven't seen this one for a long time. Dressing room prank may sideline Kutsov. Buffalo defensive Alexander Kutsov may miss a week's worth of games due to a prank gone wrong, according to teammates. Alice Kotalik decided to try and give Kutsov a fright by donning a mask and sneaking up on him in the shower. The prank worked.
Did you write that one?
Unfortunately for the Sabres, it worked a little too well. Kutsov apparently was so startled by the intrusion that he instinctively flung his arm around to defend himself and unintentionally hit his hand against the shower knob. Sustained a bruised thumb. Alexander was surprisingly good-natured about the incident, said head coach Brian Sutter. Nonetheless, he'll be out the next few games, and that's going to hurt us. Sutter declined to say whether or not Kotalik would be disciplined for the prank, but he says that he does not believe... It says that he does believe he is sincerely remorseful for what happened. I know Alice feels worse about it than anyone, but I'll have to decide whether or not that's sufficient punishment. I don't remember if I wrote that one or not, or if that was Andrew, but man.
Might that's... be a leftover from the OTP list.
Well, we rewrote most of those things, so. Or change them up into different stories, but yeah, that's still funny. I haven't seen that one in a long time. Joe Thurton hurt. And suspension. Just going to put Moore on the first line for a few games. And 3-2 win over Detroit. Number one star, Daniel Cleary.
And Sean Avery's still hanging around in Detroit. How much, how bad do they hate him now?
That's a great question. Let's take a look. Oh, good. And Antropov just got suspended for a game. Detroit.
Calm down a little bit. But the team's broken up into four cliques now. And Avery's is the biggest. And he's also got McCarty and Osgood on his side. Yeah. A couple of other guys.
Now Alan McCauley, too. Yeah,
Jim. Oh, that team's a mess.
Disruptive hostility. Just everybody just wants to punch everybody else. Sergei Fedorov is fighting with Sean Avery. Sean Avery is fighting with just about everybody else. All right. Okay, we're going to have to call somebody up. I was hoping he was going to be ready, so... Our top prospects are either playing for us or goaltenders, so we're going all the way down to Zekin, yeah. But we still have Pascal Dupuis who can come up. He's got 3 points in five games. What's
and he's at one star, and Zekin's only at half a star. Zinoviev is one star, too. So is Kyle Wellwood, actually.
Let's bring Kyle Wellwood up for a game. Questions.
Why not?
Yeah. Actually, there might have been a guy who'd be five teams in real life, right? He'd be close.
Don't think so.
Jets, Leafs, San Jose.
Oh, yeah, San Jose, right? Four. I think that's it, though. Yeah, that's it. That's all the ones he actually played for.
Is it? Are you checking the stats to be sure?
I'm looking at the page in the game.
That's what I meant, yeah.
Yeah.
What number is he going to be, or did he get a number? All right, let's see here. Okay, didn't give him a number. What number does Kyle Wellwood want to be? He wants to be 13, right? No. He can be 31, which is really odd for a player, but you go with it, Kyle Wellwood. Oh, no. Oh, too late.
Yeah, on the second line?
No, that wasn't what my worry was. He was listed as a screener. But we still went 6-3.
Yeah, Wellwood is not a guy who went to the front of the net a lot.
He got an assist.
Circled around the outside, mainly.
Got an assist.
A good first game. Couple from Rue, too.
58 offensive rating, 83 defensive game rating. Nothing wrong with that. Let's just take a look and see if that is actually his best tactic.
Oh, no chance.
His screener is 13. Actually, that is his highest rank, up and down winger. It's 13. But yeah. Do you put him at up and down winger or leave him as a screener?
I'd go with something more offensive. Let's play. It's
perimeter shooter?
Dangler would be the most well would like one.
All right, we'll put him to that then. But he's out of the lineup because Achupov is back. And I'm yawning already. That's a good sign. Kovalchuk still hurt. And Kovalchuk is almost ready to go, so we'll give him the next couple games off. Chicago, let's throw in Lettinen for his first game of the year. And we have a 1-0 loss. Scored one goal. We got a shot by one. 40 penalty minutes. All right. Brian McCabe fought Alex Burrows. Brian McCabe fought Lubomir Vyšnovský. Brian Mir fought Marek Sedlicki. We took a bench minor. That's not good. Nicholas Havlid fought Lubomir Vyšnovský, and Vyšnovský got a 10-minute misconduct for that for a second fight.
The 22 penalty minutes for Vyšnovský. It's got to be a career high.
Nope, don't want to do that. There we go. And 3-0 win over Florida. Ruutu, Williams, and Zidlicki all score. Including a power play goal. All right. Trent Klott is on the waiver wire.
A little old.
Yes. And we're going to bring back in Kovalchuk because he's ready to go. Now, so Kovalchuk's back in it. First line left wing.
Bergeron's up to 2 stars.
Nice. And that's why I was thinking about what will Florida do with Pavel Bure? 33 years old, only has 2 goals on the year. What's his look like?
Oh,
his
season's only, 7 or 8 games old? Yeah, his. These are going to be a problem.
Game for San Jose. And 4-2 win over San Jose. All right. And, Team Mussolini hits 900 points, not with us. We sent him to L.A. How's he doing on the air? He's got 3 points in 8 games.
So, not good, apparently.
Well, this was the year he was actually probably happy to have the lockout. Because he got his knees operated on.
And then after that, he started. That at least was 180-point season, or...
No, he had a 96-point season. Yeah. And we lose to Colorado again. We just can't beat Colorado. Now, there's another guy everyone kind of forgets about. Sergei Samsonov is the number one star. Kovalchuk's got a second goal. I don't think Colorado was that good of a team that they should be winning all these games versus us, but... Maybe they are.
Still got Patrick Roy in at 39.
He's, I guess, yeah. 3-2 loss versus Edmonton.
Yeah, he's 2 years past his retirement date. Real life.
Put up 40 shots on Edmonton and we lose. They only get 18. we got stonewalled by Michael Tellquist, just as everyone expected. Oh, worse, we give up 3 goals in the third period, including being up to Rem Murray beats. Ugh. Florida is offering to send us back Willie Mitchell for Dominique Moore.
It'd be a good trade, but you don't really need any more defensemen.
No, we don't. Plus, we don't really need Willie. Yeah, we don't really need Willie Mitchell back again.
He's still got another 8-10 years in him.
Oh, yeah. And 3-1 win over Minnesota.
Kovalchuk finally gets a couple.
5 goals on the year now in 11 games. Aki Pekki Berg is on waivers.
What do you got the alert set to? 1.5?
I think so, yeah, because we were looking for guys for so long.
That's why it's coming up so often.
Well, maybe there'll be a young guy at some point who's interesting. All right, big month for Cronwall is named Player of the Month.
Yeah, they traded him for Yashin, so apparently that's working out well for Ottawa.
Yeah, Dominic Hasek still playing for Buffalo, age 39. Oh, there you go, top 2 jerseys: Paul Kariya, Montreal Canadiens; Seku Koivu, Montreal Canadiens.
And then Mario in third.
Mm-hmm.
Wearing number 9 for the Devils.
Team Miscellany's number 12.
And absolutely no Columbus Blue Jackets.
No. Let's see here. Bergeron, yeah, 2. Burrows is up to 2.5 with screening. Kyle Wellwood. I guess we could send Kyle Wellwood back down. Mark Flood. Dustin Boyd. He had a big jump. Wow. And only Rick Jackman's going down.
No, lads up to 1 star. I think he might have been there already.
I'm not sure. All right. I'm going to send... Oh, Dominic Moore is actually hurt with a bruised neck, so I'm not going to send Kyle Wood down right now. Monthly budget. I think we're doing okay.
Scouting's kind of low.
We don't really need the huge scouting. We have a pretty good idea, I think, don't we?
Well, it's historical, so you can kind of cheat, but yeah.
Well, Brad Bondier. There's a name I haven't heard for a long time, too. Oh, this was past his real life last season. Okay.
Well, he probably would have played in that in the lockout year.
Maybe. He must have. Did he go overseas? Feels like he'd be a guy who would have went overseas.
Oh, but here, no, not really. He's defenseman. That's not really a...
overseas thing, yeah. David Moss, 2.5-star potential. Only 22. Don't recognize the name that well.
No, Bombardier played 1 AHL game in 2005-06 after lockout.
And then was like, okay.
That was it. And he's been Minnesota's director of player development since 2010.
David Moss, 178 points in real life in 501 games. He wouldn't be the worst pickup, but I don't think we really need him.
Versatile.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Rhett Warner. Sergei Samsonov is leading the league in points. That's odd. Kovalchuk.
That was a first round or first overall pick.
Samsonov was?
Yep. Oh, no, he wasn't. No, he was supposed to go first for a while, and he wound up going. He dropped down quite a bit.
I was going to say, I don't recall him going first.
97, overall. Yeah. He was supposed to be the number. It was him and Thornton for number one. And Thornton, I think Marlowe, too, passed him towards the end of the season, and he slid down the list a little bit. But still had a pretty good career.
We have slipped into second place in the Central. Yeah. 6-2 win over Minnesota, so at least we're beating up Minnesota every chance we get. Actually, you know, talking about...
That was just lucky. Two shorthanded goals to start the second.
Yeah. On two very different plays, yeah. No, we were talking about trying to think of guys for Puck Doku. And we started talking about Russian players, and then somebody said Samsonov. And I'm like, no, that's not the guy I was thinking of, because I was trying to think of the guy who played for Washington but never did anything until he was in his final contract year. And then he went to Carolina and was the same, and then he did in Montreal and was the same too. And I was forever trying to think of his name, and now I've lost it again and I can't think of it.
Washington, Carolina, Montreal. How recently?
Like, probably he's been out of the league for 10 years.
And he was right. You're sure he was Russian?
Yes, I'm 100% sure he was Russian.
Trying to think. Oh, Alexander Seaman.
Seaman, yes, that's right. Yep.
No, he was actually good for like most of the time in Washington.
He was great in his contract years. 3-1 win over the Leafs. We're continuing to dominate the Leafs. Most teams, we just can't beat. Colorado is just killing us. Only lost 4 games. And I'm going to continue here back to back. So let's give Kari Lehtinen another game. See how he does. And Kari Lehtinen coming in, picks up a win for us. Back-to-back wins. 2-1. Ooh, Boston is 2-10-4. Ooh. Overtime win for us, too. And Patrice Bergeron got injured. What? Oh, Eric Cole got suspended playing against us. He's got to miss his next 3 games. Oh, Cole's finally flourishing in Boston. He's over a point a game.
Yeah, because they haven't got much else. It's him, Thornton, Chris Drury, and then it gets a little scary after that.
Let's throw in more. Bergeron's only got 2 assists on the year. And 3-1 victory over LA. Kovalchuk has another couple goals. He's up to 12 now on the year. Red Wings and David Legio. Why do I know that name?
Legio wasn't playing.
Why do I know that name? David Legio.
Didn't play in the league.
I know, but I know that name. Did he play for the Moose?
Gotta look it up.
5-1
win over Chicago. Moose played. Was a third string goalie for the Americans in the 2018 Olympics. Wait, why would that? Oh, yeah, that was the.
First time the NHL was doing
well.
Datsyuk, yeah, 5-1. We're just beating up Chicago.
Wow, Nashville 2-10 and something, I think.
Oh, that's why I know that name.
What?
Well, he played for the Grizzly Adams, who was a team I followed for a while, the German league. But he was also the guy who kept knocking the goalposts off. When like he was getting on a, when a guy was coming on a breakaway.
So he would back into it and push it off?
Yeah, so then they specifically created a rule against him. Big win against Chicago again. Yeah, I forgot about it. That's why I know that name.
Cool. Chuck leading the league in goals. So, yeah, putting him on the first line apparently was a good idea.
He was on the first line. He played the entire time on the first line. And we just lost Visnovsky for a while. So Sutton's coming in. Ah, there we go, too. And look, yeah, he accepted a tryout offer from the Winnipeg Jets in 2015.
Didn't sign him?
Nope, they didn't sign him. But see, I did know that name from the Jets. 5-1 win over Pittsburgh. Oh, wait, I just thought of something. If Boston's terrible this year, they could end up with a first overall pick, which could get them Sidney Crosby. Sidney Crosby in Boston. That would be interesting.
Edmonton. Nashville is also terrible, so you could wind up with Crosby. And didn't they get Malkin in the... Yeah, they could. Malkin and Crosby could wind up together in Nashville instead of Pittsburgh. Oof.
All right, we tied Edmonton, so we didn't lose them. Okay, so I'm not crazy. I'm glad I checked Legio to figure out where I knew that name from. And it was Jets thing. So it's like playing Puck Doku. I always try and think of Jets connections because the Jets have been around long enough. And we tied this game 1-1? We back-to-back tied games 1-1.
Well, last year you'll be able to do that. Shootout's coming in next year.
Dun, dun, dun. And we're just going to continue kind of simming through. Actually, these guys are probably ready to come back in the lineup, so I should get them back in now. 3-1 win over Carolina. Jeff Hackett's in net for Carolina.
Kolchuk with another goal. What are your scoring, team scoring look like?
I'm just looking here for a second. Going to advance here for a minute. Okay, Patrice Bergeron's ready. Visnovsky's ready, so let's get them back into the lineup. Oh, we just lost Derek Roy. I don't even know what that is. Olecranon bursitis?
I think that's a shoulder thing.
Okay.
Shoulder or elbow.
Visnovsky's back. Okay. War comes out, gets replaced with Bergeron. Roy's going to come out. And you know what? We're going to give Kyle Wellwood a game. And then we'll look at stats after this game. Because I didn't forget.
Interesting fourth line. Steve Yzerman, Patrice Bergeron, and Kyle Wellwood.
2-2 tie. Again, we continue to tie. Actually, I just saw. Did you see who Anaheim's captain is? Did you see that quickly flashed? Hey, go look on their team page, see if it's there. Cardinals fans says, go Blues. Oh, like Trevor Dosky. Yeah, that cracks me up. Okay. Stats. Stats summary. Kovalchuk's leading us with 25 points in 20 games. Then Zdlicky's got 18 in 24. Datsyuk has 18 in 24. Rafalski's
got 24. Datsyuk's finished scoring good. So it should take the scoring in general should take a big jump forward next season.
Nedved, who I think we probably still got to get rid of here soon, 17 points in.
Yeah, you might maybe just keep him through the playoffs and let him walk.
We'll see. We shall see. All right, Cardinals fan, how dare you say that? Top players of the month was Mario Lemieux and Ed Belfour. Belfour is still with Dallas in 2004. He was with Toronto at this point. I think this was his last year in the league. Or was it the year before? Was he over in Sweden at this point?
No, he had a few years.
Did he go to San Jose? Was that before Toronto or not? I can't remember.
From the Leafs, and one season in Florida, and then
Florida.
One season in the Swedish second division.
I forgot about the year in Florida. All right, lots of guys going up. It's our young guys going up. Christopher Stieg with a big bump. Nedved is going down. Yzerman is down to 1.5 now. So, Mika Kiprasov has climbed into the top 20 jersey sales. He's actually outpacing Timo Salani.
Oh, Korea is still at number one in Montreal. They signed him as a free agent. How's he doing, by the way?
Paul Kariya.
He's coming off. He was nearly at a 100-point season last year in Anaheim.
Montreal Canadiens, they are feeling very harmonious. Paul Kariya has 23 points in 23 games.
Pretty good.
We did try to sign him, but he wanted way too much money.
Yeah.
And we didn't have the budget for it either. Our owner took so much money from us. Owner confidence update. Everybody's happy. We're at plus 100 still. Everything's blue. Can't really complain about that. If we have one person show up getting ready to fight, we might send them packing their bags. And versus the Blues, we lose 3-0. Thanks a lot, Cardinals fan. We got held to 18 shots.
That's a really good Blues team, though.
Yeah, Markov is hurt. Gone for 7 days. So Andy Sutton gets back in the lineup. Oh boy, he's down to 1 star.
We got to have somebody better than him in the minors.
I'm just going to just try and shop him right now and see if we get no offers for Andy Sutton.
Bring up Omeister Fanuf.
Take a look at our depth chart here. Omeister has passed him. Fanuf is 19. Yanni Pikkanen. Andy Green. Stefan Cronwall. Alex Edler isn't signed. Rick Jackman, Derek Englund. Yeah, I guess Bomeister's coming up. I'm surprised he has fallen off. I don't think Sutton was that bad at the beginning of the year. Gov gets replaced with Fener Bomeister, not Fanuf. I have too many active players now, so we're going to take Kyle Wellwood, replace him with Dominique Moore. And we're going to send Wellwood back down to Syracuse. Cardinals fans, sorry, not sorry. Oh, you will be. You will be. Stefan Cronwall is still going to be a very long time before he's feeling good about being here. It's too bad. Playing versus the Canucks. So, Jeff, did you program it for us to lose?
Of course.
Well, we won because you had Miroslav. Oh, Satan still scored.
9-15. The Canucks are doing a little better in this game. They've slipped backwards a bit.
Now, he didn't actually play for the Canucks, did he?
Chatan? No, they traded him for McGillney.
Right. And producer Bergeron got hurt. What? Hurt? Oh, he's lightly hurt.
It was Chatan, Ryan Miller for Andrew Castles and McGillney. And Castles apparently was... didn't had a couple of decent seasons in Buffalo. Then they sent him to New Jersey, and he's still going. He's 35. And McGillney's still there.
Oh, boy. That's tempting. McGillney's
still in Buffalo.
Brent Johnson is on waivers.
What? Go back. Check how that happened.
I'm going to. He's contract. He signed for 2.97 for the next 4 years.
Yeah, which is probably more than you afford. But what
prompted that? Yeah. They have Backstrom and Telquist.
Wait, Telquist. When did they get Telquist?
They traded for him. Blues get Telquist and Mike Van Ryan, gave up Brad Stewart and a second round pick.
And they overpaid for him too. That's a weird trade.
They are saving quite a bit of money for that.
Oh yeah, what's their... they don't really look forward to cap though, so I don't think that's a problem, but they are, yeah, that is going to help their cap situation considerably.
Not to mention they're dumping next a guy year. Who's on a four-year contract.
Oh, wait, what's their budget? Yeah, they're getting close-ish to their budget. Yeah, okay, so that's a salary thing.
Should we claim him?
No, you're stuck with him for the year, though, and then you're going to wind up losing Lettinen, who's much cheaper. I'd leave him.
All right, I'm sure somebody else is going to pick him up. Oh, Felix.
Contract might be the only thing.
Felix Potvin is on waivers. The cat.
Then Robert Reichel. Bring him back again.
Oh, yeah, there we go. The Wild picked up Brent Johnson, so they got him, and then they dumped Felix. Well, the good news is we might finally beat St. Louis now. Jason LaBarbera in net for Rangers, and we beat them. Score two goals early and then just hold on for the lead. I got to look at that again. Hold on a second. We are tied for the league lead in points.
Yeah, with New Jersey, Nashville's doing a little better. Now, how's Ovechkin doing in Carolina? They're close to 500, better than they were last year. Is that all on him?
Ovechkin. 23 points in 29 games.
Yeah, pretty good start. Because he's got Stahl, but Neil too. I got one line.
Ovechkin is playing third line with Robert Petrovicki.
And that may not be accurate, though.
And Shavicki, or that's where he's listed.
Yeah.
He is on power play, which might be where he's making lots of points.
Yep, first line.
All right. How's Bergeron doing? 70%. Yeah, okay, I'll let him go for one more game. And we beat Nashville 3-1. Kovalchuk was the 18th. Zdlicky scores again shorthanded. All right, Derek Roy is ready to return. So let's get Bergeron out of the lineup till he's healthy. So Moore gets replaced with Roy. Bergeron gets replaced by Moore. All right. We'll throw back in Lettinen again here for this game versus the Islanders. And Roberto Luongo, we beat them 3-0. Cleary with a number one, 2 assists.
He's been first star a couple of times.
Uh-huh. We score 3 goals in the third period for the win. including Tomo Ruti scoring shorthanded. Our shorthanded, our special teams are doing really well. All right, everyone's basically back up to 100. Nashville, and we lose to Nashville 3-2. Mike Sillinger. Derek Roy scores shorthanded. Sidlicky scores on the power play, but we lose the tie with just under 5 minutes left. And we just lost Visnovsky for 8 days with a hip pointer. Who? Bollmeister's coming in and is putting Markov back in. Visnovsky's coming out, and we're putting Bollmeister back in. Alex Auld gets traded to Colorado.
Where does he? Has Daze gone downhill at this point? Daze for Zednik.
Zednik, yeah, and a second round pick.
Oh, yeah, Daze is down to 2 stars and only had 7 points last year.
All right. Game versus Minnesota, and we beat them 5-0. Wait, Minnesota's goal to... Oh, we held Minnesota to 15 shots. Oh, Steve...
They had Johnson in goal?
Nope, they had Nabokov, or at least they did at the end. Yeah, Nabokov. Steve Yzerman fights Jean-Guy Trudel? I don't even know that name. Dominic Moore fights Merrick Malik. All right. Just the guys you would expect to be fighting.
You got nobody, no tough guys on your team to fight for them, so.
We have tough guys in the minors, but.
It makes it a little hard for them to do anything on the ice.
All right, fine. When Anthony Peluso comes up, I will draft him, Jeff. 2-1 loss to Calgary. All right, Bergeron's back and ready to go. So let's get him back in the lineup. Replace Bergeron. All right, I'm going to take Markov out and put in Andy Sutton for the game. Markov's only at 49%. So Sutton can come in and play a game. 2-1 loss. Andy Sutton fights Jason Blake and then takes a 10-minute misconduct on top of it. No, I'm sorry. Andy Sutton fought Caberle. Zdeno Chara fought Jason Blake. Back-to-back fights.
And no other penalties? Oh, no, there's a couple in the second.
Yeah. Okay,
Visnovsky. Who's catching up to you?
Back. Okay, so... Bollmeister gets replaced with Visnovsky. Sutton gets replaced with Bollmeister. Yeah, we're going to put Lettinen in for this game. And sim it out, and 2-1 loss. We just can't. Our goal scoring has stopped. Scored once in the first period, just over 2 minutes in. Gave up 2 goals in the third period. Bobby Holik trade rumor. Game versus San Jose. Trevor Kidd still hanging around the NHL. 3-3 tie. Out shooting them, just can't quite get her done. Trade proposal from Ottawa. Ooh, yes. Tyler Bozak for Andy Sutton. Yes.
Yeah, Bozak's not anything at this point, but yeah, definitely do that. You got lots of spare defensemen.
Yeah, we'll send Bozak back down. That's a good trade for us. Really? Tyre Bozak played last year? 21-22. Okay.
Yep. Well, 2 years ago now, technically.
Yeah, did he not play last year? Or he retired? I don't know.
Nope, I don't think he was a free agent all year, and I can't remember when we... Yeah, he's retired in the database. I can't remember what point we did that. Does he actually have a retirement announcement? Nope. Just never got signed.
Hmm. 3-1 win over Nashville. Well, at least Nashville gets us back in the winning ways.
Does Nashville have Malkin in the lineup, or are they really trying to tank and get the Crosby pick?
Okay, we just lost Robida. So I'm going to deal with that first. Bomeister gets replaced. Markov comes back in. Robida's out 2 to 3 weeks. Bomeister. Sorry, Nashville, you said? Quick look says he's not in the lineup.
Bomeister got another half star. He's up to 2 now.
That's depth chart says.
So maybe when Robidoux comes back.
Malkin is playing in the minors.
Yep. He's only 18.
Yeah, he's got 26 points in 33 games in the minors. Yeah, Malkin's in the minors, but they have Patrick Eves on their team, Jeff. So. Yeah.
And actually, Dasher looks like they're going to be good in a few years. Weber.
They should be good.
Joe Pavelski. Patrick Sharp.
Cam Martin.
Coming in the high draft. Yeah.
2-0 win over Dallas. All right. Best role model is Steve Yzerman. Best skaters, Paul Kariya. Hardest shot is Dennis Wiedemann. Toughest Wade Bielak. Fastest, Paul Kariya. Cleanest is Sergei Bereson. Richard Leitner. Alexander Daigle is still hanging on.
He's not gone away to make movies yet.
Chris Chelios is in Dallas. He's underrated at 42 years old. Brad Larson.
Everybody's writing him off still. He's got another
Dominic
Hasek. 5 years left of him.
Okay.
6 years.
Sure. And New Year's Eve game. Let's give it to Kipper. And 3-0 victory over Florida. Peter Nedved, 2 assists. Number 1 star. And Markov is out again, hurt. Patrice Bergeron goes up. Pavel Datsyuk. Kovalchuk's at 4 stars now. Was he at 4 stars before?
I don't think so, no. He was, 3.5.
Yeah. So he's hitting his peak. What's other guys going up? Oh, there you go. Mazikin is now at 1 star, Jeff.
I already was.
Was he? I thought he was at 0.5 star when we looked at him.
Oh, you're right, he was. Yeah, I said 1 now.
Oh, okay. Not bad. Let me just look here. Upcoming free agents. Yeah, we signed basically everyone. Dominic Moore, though, and Peter Nedved. We were just leaving. Chris Neal really hasn't done much, so he's probably going to go to free agency. Jackman's going downhill, so he's out. Monthly budget. Yeah, well, I might as well go up high up in team morale. Okay, so we got to call up Oh, wow. Dion Phaneuf has fallen down. Yanni Pikkanen's up above him as well as Andy Green.
Yeah, Phaneuf's the only one that's 1.5 stars.
Why is he falling behind the other two, though?
Slightly higher potential, maybe. But no, I'd call Phaneuf up.
Yeah, you're the one who made me draft him. So Markov gets replaced with Phaneuf. Dion, we're going to give him the number 8.
Check his role too.
Tactics player.
And do it from his player window, but too.
We're going to change screener. I don't think we need old school defenseman. Crease clearing defenseman.
That or two-way?
We'll send him a two-way. And 2-1 loss to Tampa Bay. Falling behind both Ottawa and New Jersey now for the league lead. St. Louis is only 2 points back of us.
Ottawa's still on top, even after getting rid of Yashin.
Game versus Nikolai Habibulin in Vancouver, and they beat us 3-0. Ouch. Blowing it, Jeff. We're blowing it.
And Canada wins the World Juniors.
Wait. What?
You didn't have him in the... you called him up after he was put in the lineup. So that's a glitch with the way the roster selection works. He won't get marked as int. Because he wasn't on... an active team.
So he's here, but he's not here? But he's here.
Basically, yeah.
So he's just flying back and forth between the games.
Pretty much.
Well, that is some commitment. Two one loss. He is not doing well for us right now, though. And okay, Markov is already recovered. Put Lettinen in for this game. And 3-0 victory now. There we go, that's better. Kovalchuk with a goal and assist. Let's go to that lines. And Bergeron got hurt. What are you doing, Bergeron? Broken hand, 1 to 2 months.
Ouch. Well, he was developing well.
So Moore's coming in. Bergeron's going...
injured list.
Injured list, which means we need to call up a forward.
Bring Wellwood back, or are you gonna give Mazjakin or Dupuis a chance? No, Dupuis only 0.5 star, and Neil's 0.5 star.
Dupuis 1 star.
Oh, yeah, he's one.
All right, we're gonna give Mazjakin a chance. We'll see how that goes, if he needs to step into the lineup. No, we are not delaying treatment on Bergeron. Mazikin wants 10. He can have 16. Good. He's happy with that. Game versus Anaheim. All right. Sim it out and 4-1 victory. All right. A couple of wins in a row here. Jeff, I guess we've been doing this for over an hour already.
Take a quick look at the team scoring before you go. You're about halfway through the season.
All right. We are 27-12-4, just so we know. Taking a quick look at our standings first. We are currently first in the Central and first in the Western Conference. Yes. So we'd actually play Team Mussolini's LA Kings in the first round if it ended today. And team scoring, Jeff wanted to know. So stats summary. Kovalchuk's got a point per game pace finally. He's actually outdone his best. He's now 39 goals, or 39 points in 39 games. Zidlicky's got 30 in 43. Datsyuk's got 28 in 43. McDonald's 27. Nedved's 27. Rafalski's 25 in 43. Antropov's 23 in 42. Overall, not bad, Jeff.
Yeah, no, pretty good. Antropov not really producing as much as he has before, but I mean, the plus minuses are nice too. What if Wisnowski plus 24?
Yeah. Yeah, our defense seems to be holding us together quite well. But with that,
Iserman. Look at Iserman's line. Ouch.
Yeah, I don't want to look too carefully. He's our captain playing limited minutes. 5-0 victory over Nashville. Kovalchuk gets 3 assists. All right, with that, I guess, Jeff. Oh, man, Danny Cleary got injured. All right, just because we can, Cleary is only slightly hurt. We're going to put in Moisiak in for this game. See how he does for this next game. Trade proposal from Washington. They want to send us Emmanuel Peter for Moore, which is going to get rejected. All right, we're going to give Kipper the back-to-back. Sim it out, and 4-1 victory. Kovalchuk again, 2 assists. All right, taking a look. Moziak on 62 offense, 70 defense. One shot on goal, 2 hits. And just over 12 minutes of ice time. Nothing wrong with that, Jeff.
Nope.
All right, so with that, thank you very much for tuning into another Franchise Hockey Manager stream. We typically stream every Wednesday night at 10 p.m. Eastern on twitch.tv/franchisehockeymanager as well as twitch.tv/OOTPDevelopments. All of our streams are archived on our YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/OOTPDevelopments as well, going live Sundays at about 3 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Were you, just so that they're live for everyone during the day, including our European viewers. You can also reach out to us on our Facebook page, which is facebook.com/franchisehockeymanager. We're on Twitter for now, which is at Franchise Hockey. You can also find a link to our official Discord. We are on Threads as Franchise Hockey Manager, I think. Or what is it as I look quickly? Yeah, Franchise Hockey Manager.
I think it is, yeah.
You can also reach out to us on official Discord if I didn't say that. And, of course, our official website is ootpdevelopments.com. Click on the top community button in the top right-hand corner, which will bring you to the official forums. You can talk about Franchise Hockey Manager, Out of the Park Baseball, Perfect Team Go, or anything else you wish to discuss. Jeff, did I miss anything?
No, I think we pretty much covered everything there. Not too much new to report. Still working on FHM10. Have something to say about that a little later. Who did you want to even lose?
Didn't lose. No, it was about FHM10. We'll talk about it eventually, but it's going to be for a while, not for a while. And there's another storyline we haven't seen very often. Dustin Penner's home is robbed.
Is that the Magic Gloves one? No, is it Lucky Gloves? No, no, it's a different one.
Yeah, no. All right. With that, We'll be back next week again with our Wisconsin Badgers stream where Jeff tries to not win another championship, right? That's what you're going for?
Well, I'm going to pretty much be successful at it this year because we got some really bad news in the offseason.
Oh, no.
But we'll tell you that next week.
All right. Sounds good. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. We will see you all again next week.